إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. We've given you the greatest, the most abundant good.
There are three threats in the Quran. Please don't forget that. If you study the entire Quran, there are three kinds of threats, three kinds of warnings. The first warning is, nation, if you don't listen to your prophet, you're going to be destroyed. That was the warning given to the people of Nuh, Lut, Salih, Shu'aib, alayhim as-salam, Fir'aun, you name it. Those were the people that were given warnings. If you don't listen, your nation shall be destroyed. Right? That's the first kind of threat in the Quran. The second kind of threat is what will happen to people on Judgment Day. Okay? The death, by the way, is not a threat. Because death is a reality. I'm not threatening you, one day you'll die. Like, thanks, I already knew that. That's not a threat. So the first threat is destruction of nations. The second threat is Judgment Day, where you will be held accountable, where you will be brought to trial. The trial is the threat. The third threat in the Quran is hell. So there's three. Destruction of nations. What else did I say? Let me hear it from you. Day of Judgment, and then hell. Now, the thing about destruction of nations is, do people know when it's coming? No. وَلَيَأْتِيَنَّهُمْ بَغْتَةً وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ It will come to them all of a sudden, and they'll have no realization. The mercy of Allah is that our messenger was the last messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. With him ended the destruction of nations. There is no more destruction of nations. That's done. Okay, so that's a mercy from Allah azza wa jalla, that door of threat closed forever. The last time those threats were issued, they were issued to Quraysh. That's it. There's no more that one nation will be completely annihilated or wiped out or whatever else, okay? So when this is especially, see a flood happen in some country and see Allah ka azab hai dekho zara, shame on you. That's not what Quran says. That's what your, you know, Pindu interpretation was. You need to stop doing that. That is a test from Allah, not a azab of Allah. We don't say that's a azab from Allah, that's a torture from Allah. We don't say that, okay? Now, anyway, so there were three threats. One of them comes to people, they have no clue. They have no clue what's going on. An earthquake came, a flood came, nobody even knows what's happening, and all of a sudden they're done. Isn't it? But if you look at these ayat, كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ They will know. Oh yeah, they will know. Which means there are two punishments where people will what? They will know. I told you how many threats are there? Three. But one of them, people won't even know what's happening. Which is which one? Destruction of nations. What are the two left? Day of Judgment? Hellfire. When Judgment Day begins, people are terrified. Oh, and then they know, oh my God. This is... And وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا They will find everything they did standing in front of them. They will know. But even that isn't knowing until they see hell. Because right now they're seeing you're guilty. What are they not seeing? The jail that awaits you. When they see that jail, then they realize, no, that when I realized I'm guilty, I still didn't realize how serious it was until I saw that jail. There are two levels of realization for criminals. One on Judgment Day, the other on the Day of Resurrection. One on Judgment Day, the other on the day they see, at the end of it, when they see hellfire. One of them is كلا سيعلمون. The next one is what? ثم كلا سيعلمون. And ثم is تراخي. It's a long time. ثم doesn't just mean moreover. It actually means then after a long time they'll realize again. Oh, wait till they see it again. In this, Allah has basically said to the criminals, you are going to be singing a different tune on Judgment Day. Wait till you see it. Oh boy, and wait till you see what? Hell on top of that. And you'll notice as the surah continues, Allah will first describe Judgment Day, then He'll describe hellfire. He'll actually Himself do tafsir of كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ And then what? ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ He'll explain it Himself. SubhanAllah.